this section's all about formatting content, about making things look pretty. And the first thing we're going to concentrate on are changing the font and applying styles. Everyone knows how to change fonts in Word. The easiest way to do it is to select what you want to change, and then up here you have your font selection. I'm not going to go over everything, but make sure you know how to change fonts. For instance, up here, change the size, make sure you understand and are confident using all of these. But there's more that you can do to fonts as well. By clicking this button here, alternatively you can right click on a font, on text, and go to font. You open up the font dialog box. You have the option here to do a whole load of other things, like strike through should you want, which puts a line through it. You can double strike through to have two lines. You can make them all into small caps. Let's take that off. You can underline things on here as well, and so on and so forth. If you go to the Advanced tab, this is where things get a little bit more technical. You have the character spacing, which is the amount of space you have between the individual characters, and you can make that either smaller or greater, which will change the appearance, of course, on the screen. The positioning, and you have the kerning as well. All of these change the way that your font appears. What I would like you to do now is to get some text. It can be any old random text, and put it on a page of Word, and I want you to go through every single one of these parts of the font tab and on the Advanced tab and see the effect it has on the text. Because any question that comes up which is to do with changing the font or changing the way that the text appears, you will almost certainly find it here. The only other thing you need to know about here is if you go into text effects, this gives you the ability to again change the physical appearance of the text by doing things like filling with certain colours or putting shadow or reflection on, and so on and so forth. So, pause the video now, open up a blank Word document, put some text on, and explore all of these features. So, that was all about applying font attributes. Now we're going to look at something more wide-reaching, and that's applying the styles. And styles are a way to ensure that you have a consistent appearance for your documents all the way through. So, again, if you want to apply a style, this is all on the Home tab. You have the big styles selection here, and if you drop down, you can see all of the ones available to you in this current style. If you change the style set over here, this will change the styles available to you at the top, but we'll keep the default. And if you want to change a paragraph, you would click within that paragraph and click there to change it, for instance. Let's change that back. Or perhaps to select all of this, we could subtly emphasize it by doing that. So these are all of your styles. This one down here, though, will show you in far more detail. So if you click on this, you have the pull-out menu here, and this gives you all of the different styles available to you. Now, if you click on Show Preview, this will make these slightly less difficult to work out, and it will show you what all of them will do to your text. And again, all you have to do is select the text you would like this to apply to, and click on the style. Some of these have an A next to them, which means they're for characters. Others have the paragraph symbol, which means that they apply to complete paragraphs. So scroll through all of those and give them a little try out. Make sure you understand not necessarily what they all are, but you understand how to access them. The last thing that I'd like you to be aware of before we go on to the next section is the options here. If you click on options, this allows you to limit the styles that you can see. So you can, for instance, only choose the styles that are recommended. So these are only the ones that Word recommends what we currently have, or possibly even the ones in the current document, and this is going to be very few because we only have heading and normal. So what I'd like to do now is to, again on a document, is to go through and change some of the styles, change the style set, open the style tab, dialogue pane rather, and have a play around with that and with the options. And then you're ready to go on to the next section.